Greetings to you in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. On this Tuesday evening, I bring you strength from the sanctuary. It has been a tremendous joy during this Holy Week to update you, to bring you up to speed on what is taking place here in the life of the Aldersgate United Methodist Church in the city of Huber Heights, Ohio, as we march towards the reality of the revealing of the Messiah, HaMashiach of God, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, 2,000 years ago, as he gave his life as a ransom that you and I might have life and that more abundantly. It is a blessing to be able to come to you on this evening. And so we find in the 42nd chapter of the book of Isaiah, we find here the servant, a light to the nations. And as Jesus did come, and as Christ gave his life and shed his innocent, his precious blood, Christ truly was the servant of God who came to seek the ransomed, those who needed redemption. And Christ is a light to the nations, to as many as were called upon the name of God, to those who are far off. We have been called by God. We've been chosen by God in him, even before the foundations of the world. But there's a beautiful hymn of praise after we read in Isaiah, the 42nd chapter, about the servant of God, the light to the nations. There's a tremendous hymn of praise that Isaiah gives to us. And we lift this praise this evening as our devotion on this Tuesday during Holy Week. The writer says, sing unto the Lord a new song, his praise from the ends of the earth. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the coastlands and all their inhabitants. Let the desert and its towns lift up their voice, the villages that Kedar inhabits. Let the inhabitants of Selah sing for joy. Let them shout from the tops of the mountains. Let them give glory to the Lord and declare his praise in the coastlands. The Lord goes forth like a soldier, like a warrior. He stirs up his fury. He cries out. He shouts aloud. He shows himself mighty against his foes. It is here in this particular chapter of the book of Isaiah that he encourages us in a song of praise that God is not against us, that God is for us. And that as God is for us and we acknowledge that we are in him, that we are to lift up a praise unto God no matter where we are. In the coastlands, near the sea, wherever we find ourselves in this present current dispensation, we are to praise the name of Almighty God for the wondrous things that he has done for us. I've often found that in dire situations in my own life that my praise is my protest. When I can't do anything else, I can praise God. And not only has my praise been my protest, but I found that in times where God has allowed something to come into my life that may have seemed foreign to me, that my pain has been the process that God used in order to reveal himself. And then finally, this song of praise reveals something still further, that often our worship becomes our witness. My praise is my protest. My pain is my process. But ultimately, my worship is my witness. If we can praise God through this current season, if we can praise God through these trying times, we will see, perceive, hear, know, and understand that the God who has called us and shaped us in his image and in his likeness is not against us, but he is for us. And if God is for us, he is more than the whole world against us. Be encouraged on this terrific Tuesday. Have faith in God. Have joy in the Lord that he who has begun a great work in you will be faithful to complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. May you be blessed as we continue on this journey during the Lenten season. And may you know that Christ in you is the hope of glory. And may you share that hope with others who have not yet come to know him. Blessed evening as we pray for you here from the sanctuary of the Aldersgate United Methodist Church And from this message, may you receive strength from the sanctuary. God bless you. We're praying for you until we meet again.